Okay.
That was high pitch as fuck. Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Iron Bros Podcast. We're here in episode 9, gathered today. Kyle, you're back from Greece, man. How was your trip?
My trip was fantastic.
Really? Tell me about it.
It was great.
Dude, come on.
So anyway.
We have like an hour-long podcast. We've got a lot to talk about.
It was, I guess, 8 days in length, split time between Mykonos and Santorini Island. Mm-hmm. I think one of the things I didn't know about Greece that perhaps you definitely don't know, but maybe other people do. There's like peak seasons, and outside of those peak seasons from May to the end of August, early September, the island's much quieter. There's a lot of places that are closed. So Mykonos, which is more of a party spot, very touristy, but definitely more of a party spot that you hear about on Instagram, things like that. A lot of the main clubs are closed, so the ones that were open either are having their closing parties. But again, when just think of like Iron Revolution. If you come here at 8 a.m., there's probably, I don't know, 10% capacity versus
5 p.m.
5, 6 p.m., where there's a ton of people here. So that was like the difference in terms of those places. Santorini Island was awesome, though. I think that's a place I'd recommend everyone go. You and Alex definitely mosey on over to Greece at some point, man.
Why weren't we invited on this trip with you?
To Greece?
Yeah, and a lot of other activities.
You guys are in your pre-prep phase. This is more important.
Before prep.
I've been still rehabbing for a year, you know? So now that I can come back, I'm going to be nice and rested and ready to implode with growth. But for you, I think, you know, if you guys ever get out there and anyone that listens to this podcast, if they can travel to Greece, Santorini Island is definitely a beautiful place. It's one of those places that it's cliche to say pictures don't do something justice, but when you're really high up on a mountain, it doesn't, we don't have technology that can translate that kind of depth to an image.
Was that your first time in Europe?
No, because I went to Ibiza last year.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
You went to Ibiza when you were injured. And
yeah, 2 days, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What was it? What was it? Your quad tour?
Ruptured quad.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, so you liked Greece. That was good.
Yeah, Greece was good. And then I believe you were also on a trip.
I was. Literally, besides yesterday, we haven't seen each other in almost 2 weeks.
Has it been that long?
Yeah, dude. I try to hang out with you, but you're busy all the time.
When were you trying to hang out with me?
Whenever. I'll hit you up to hit
and I don't answer you sometimes. I know. It's not purposely done. I'm just, you know. People think I always answer you, but that's not the case.
You go apple picking with dudes, and you don't decide to invite a double date.
Because it was a 2-hour one-way travel.
And I would have been more than happy to sit in
that
damn
car.
Crazy. With, really, Kyle?
Your knees
because,
would be crushed.
Oh, you know what? Remember that time when I drove you, me, Grant, and blank 2.5 hours through traffic to Bev's gym, I'd do it again to apple picking.
I was in prep, right?
You weren't in prep. No one was in prep.
Grant?
Yeah, it was right before we left for LA. It was in January.
Oh. You posed for Steve?
Yeah, post for Steve. We made a video out of it. The video did really well.
Yeah. That was...
But the point with that is basically saying that, you know what? I would go the distance. I would drive the miles to spend time with a pal.
What about that cruise I wasn't invited on that you and Ali went on? You remember that one?
Yeah, weren't you like fucked or something?
No. What does that mean?
The quad? You couldn't enjoy shit. You were fucked up.
I don't remember. I really don't remember.
You were probably still staying at like Ant's house at the time. It was...
I don't recall. Touche. Okay. I will always ask you. And then if you say, no, I'm not going to
broke
this
the fucking machine
again, bro. Please.
Broke the shit out of it. I did that yesterday, too, though. I had such a funny fucking incident happen yesterday at the gym that I just can't share on the podcast. It is so funny. Wow. Oh, I mentioned to you yesterday when we saw each other. And Grant knows what it is.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's an interaction.
We can't talk about it.
You could talk about it.
Bro, no shot. I'd get my ass in trouble.
Okay.
So, Greece was good. Yeah, when you were in Greece, I ended up going to L.A. I went to L.A. and I'm going back out to L.A. in 6 days.
Very nice.
And actually, we talked on message yesterday that we've got to talk about this.
We talked?
Yeah, we talked.
Go ahead.
Do you want to talk about it now? Do you want to plan it out?
Yeah, we can try to plan it out. Go ahead.
All right. So, we're going to L.A. in 6 days, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is it just you or is Alyssa coming too? Because it's just me.
So I have to decide. I have to figure out tonight. So what I was saying was everything is booked right now for Nashville. So I return on Nashville. I thought I'd come back on Sunday. I come back on Monday, which is crappy because I wouldn't have minded coming back here. But being that, I mean, we usually always go together anyway, if possible.
Mm.
However, now I can't even cancel one ticket. So like, and then to rebook her ticket, You know how it is to rebook a ticket close by. So, like, it'll probably wind up being still cheaper to just transfer to the right flight. So there's a good chance we'll both go. My main thing at first, I was worried that I wouldn't be able to go. So right now, I'll have to ditch the rental car we have, Toro. I'll just have to have somebody return it earlier. That way I can kind of leave. It's only it's an hour or less. So what is the flight from here? 5 hours to LA?
To LA, yeah.
So I think it's like 4 hours. So I'll still try to come in on the 16th. And then I guess the return flight is 18th?
19th? Mine's the 19th.
Oh, I don't mind. Yeah.
18th, I got something with Jay. And if you're there.
Yeah, because I talked to him. When I was on the way back from Greece, I texted him.
What?
Oh, shit. Fuck.
You can't
I forgot about that. No. Yeah.
When's your mom's birthday?
So the day we work out with Jay.
So how can we do it?
Jay called me to work out the 18th.
Podcast equipment, though? Is that easy to set up? All right, so we're going to have to do that. Maybe somebody can help us.
I'm sure I know how to set up the podcast equipment. I can watch a video or learn from Grant real quick.
Yeah, so I think that would be beneficial to at least capture when we're out there.
We can get podcasts out there so we can get guests in next episodes.
Yeah.
Jay Cutler, some other people.
Hopefully James.
Yes, James, Soosh, that'd be awesome. But so you said you're going to crash to James's.
Yeah, I talked to James last night.
All right, so now I'm going to talk to Weston, see if I'll be able to get through this time.
How come you didn't say it? Where did you say last time you went to LA?
Isaiah Noel's, actually, which I got a whole story for you guys. Whole story.
Oh.
But so this way we can finalize plans.
Yeah.
Look like you're going to go with Alyssa, which cool. I will go. I'll stay at Weston's. We'll connect with Young LA Photoshoot. 18th, work out with Jay Cutler. Podcasts. Kill some other podcasts.
Because the 17th would be full day, right?
17th, full day. Like, rest. Nothing else. Cool. All right, so we got that plan. All right, but yeah, Kyle, I was in LA. When you got a protein shake?
I do. It's my second meal of the day.
What time are you up?
I got up at 6.
What time did you go to bed?
Yesterday, 1:15.
You went to bed earlier than I did, but I went to bed at 2.
You getting that beef meal in, huh?
Yeah. Why'd you laugh like that? Is that vanilla? What flavor is it?
It's actually peanut butter flavor.
Oh, okay. But anyways, yeah, I went to LA for this Young LA photo shoot. Because the way they're doing the Black Friday this year, last year they had like a crazy set. They had all the athletes out there at once. They had a big production team. We had, I think, like 2 or 3 days of filming. But this year, what they did is they're doing a bunch of micro shoots or a bunch of mini shoots.
Yeah.
So they have a lot of athletes actually out there living in LA, so they're utilizing them a lot. But then some athletes like me and shit, they're flying us out there. And I had a one photo shoot. So they flew me out for one photo shoot for the Black Friday event. Which was what I went there for. So I had to plan this, right? So got my flight. Had to figure out where I was crashing. And I didn't want to get a hotel because obviously, you know, bodybuilders, we like our food.
Yeah.
We got to cook a lot. So I've done the hotel route with the burner where you plug it in, the electric burner. And it works, but it's just a hassle, bro. It's so annoying. You're in such a small space. It's all messy and shit. So we needed a kitchen. So hit up our boy Weston, you know, Weston Garland.
Weston
great
Garland.
Great client. Client. So I was supposed to stay with him. Fell through at first. No, he said yes, then it fell through. He's like, sorry, bro. I predict I'm going to get sick. I'm going to get COVID. So then you got to find somewhere else to go. Which he did get COVID. He did predict well. So I was like, you know what? I was like, I really like Isaiah Noel. So I hit up Isaiah. I was like, hey, bro. I know you're like 4 weeks out. I don't want to like step on your toes. I know you're close to show. Is it cool if I could stay with you? You got a guest room? And he's like, yeah, bro, absolutely. Come by. And I was like, cool. I was looking forward to it. Get a workout with him, help him pose, you know, because I like helping people pose and shit. So went to go stay with them. And then this whole time was, you know, something I can talk about. So the trip itself was great. It was fun. It was a good time. But let me tell you about what happened. So I'm staying with them, right? It's at Noel's, like, new house.
Yeah.
You've been there. You stayed there. So you know what? You know the layout of the house. When I got to L.A., luckily Young LA hooked me up with actually Gary's mom's car. So Isaiah had to bring me to go get that car. Then we went to go work out the first day.
Mm-hmm.
Worked out at Gold's Gym separately. I wanted to see how he looked. Mid-workout showed me how his look. Really impressive, right? His chest super full, striated. Yeah. I was like, damn, looking pretty good, bro. Took a video for him, posted it on Instagram. He did cardio post-workout. Dipped after that. We drove separately because I got my car, right? The rental car or... whatever. So he went back at his house. And this is where things get really weird. This is where the story begins. So if you guys are listening, like, listen now. So Isaiah took a shower when he got home, right? And I call him in the kitchen, and he's just complaining about cold sweats. He's like, bro, he's like, I don't feel good. He's like, I just can't stop sweating. I'm freezing. And I know what cold sweats are. I've taken Shredable before. I've taken Yohimbine.
Right.
I know what cold sweats are. So I was like, you taking Yohimbine? He's like, what the fuck is that? I was like, okay. Yohimbine's a fat burner. It causes cold sweats. He's like, I don't know. Check my supplements. He just signed with Alpha Lion, a new supplement company. And I read the back of the ingredients. It's very weird. Like, if you look at the ingredients on this, right, it says in here, it says, like, carbonated water, citric acid, or even here, Ghost Energy, Carnipure, L-carnitine, L-tartrate, right, taurine, natural caffeine. Alpha Lion, their stuff, it would be, like, it would say, like, one or two ingredients, but it was, like, a patented ingredient, I think. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but, like, it didn't have, like, a full extensive list where you would see, like, beta-alanine, citrulline, taurine.
Was it, like, more of, like, a blend?
Well, it wasn't a priority, proper.
I know what you're trying to say.
It wasn't that blend either. I wish I could remember. But if you go on their website, too, and you look on it, it was, like, hard to read the ingredients. So I basically ditched it. I was like, bro, like, I'll be honest, I got no clue if it's in here or not. I don't know what's in there.
Gosh.
So he's complaining. Noel's just patting him down with paper towels. He's making his food. I make my food. We go sit outside because it's fucking L.A., you know, Jersey, it's cold. We're talking outside, eating. And, bro, he's eating like this. So slow. I'm trying to talk to him, and he couldn't even hold a conversation. So, obviously, I know something's not right.
Mm-hmm.
He finishes eating. He's like, you know what? He's like, I never take naps, but I'm going to go take a nap real quick. I was like, all right, bro, go relax. Like, do your thing. So, I was just chilling. Noel got a new puppy 2 days ago. Like, a Frenchie bulldog. So, we're playing with the puppy, whatever. No, he takes a nap. And then then he wakes up. He comes out and he's refreshed. He's like, oh my God, I feel so much better. Thank God that helped me out. Like, I feel much better. I was like, cool, bro. So we went to go grocery shopping because I just got there, needed food. He took me grocery shopping. He has a really nice new car, M3 CS, which we were just talking about. It's a twin turbo car. Sick.
Very nice.
But anyways, takes me out in it, new grocery shopping. Come back, we eat like two more meals, like finish our meals for the night. There's like a movie on, we're like chit chatting. We took an edible, right? We're just like, kind of having fucking chilling out for the night. We all go to bed. Oh, actually, no, not yet. Because we were planning to work out the next day with each other. So I planned out my next day. I was supposed to get a tattoo at 12. Because whenever I go to LA, I try to get a tattoo. And I haven't been getting them.
Right.
Whenever I hit my artist, he's like in Mexico or somewhere. So I was luckily able to get an appointment at 12. So I was like, all right, so I got to train early in the morning. I was like, so let's aim for 8:30 at the gym. Let's eat our meal around 7:15. So I'm going to wake up around 7. He's like, cool. I'll wake up at 6:30 because I got check-ins to do. And I was like, being up a little bit earlier. I was like, you got it, bro. So he told me he's going to set his alarm or anything like that. So we go to bed. And you know the layout of the house where the guest room is. The guest room is right next to their master.
Yep.
And then Chris's room is right over there, right? So my first night sleeping, dude, I had horrible sleep. It got cold as fuck in their house. Do you remember that?
It gets cold.
Cold as fuck.
Very cold.
And I was complaining about how hot it was. I felt super rude. I was like walking around shirtless and shit.
Their air mattress or they had the bed set?
It was a pull-out couch Tempur-Pedic. So better than an air mattress, for sure.
Okay, so they got their furniture in.
Yeah, they got the furniture. Okay. I felt bad. During the day, I was walking around their house like, shit, I was just fucking hot the whole time. But at nighttime, dude, it would drop down to like 60 or like high 50s, it felt like. It was freezing. And that's where I got this cold from. I swear. My mom always told me, bro. Don't sleep in the cold, bro. Keep your head warm.
And keep the neck warm.
Yeah.
Yep.
So I woke up the next day, kind of felt like a sore throat. And this is how I woke up, ready? I kept waking up throughout the night because I kept hearing footsteps. And I was like kind of annoyed, but I'm not going to complain, right? I'm a guest, right? So whatever the footsteps were, they were. 6:30, I hear the alarm, like the typical alarm, beep, you know, from Apple.
What's the alarm sound like?
I'll play it. I don't know. I can't make the noise, Kyle.
Okay.
So 6:30 goes off, and I was exhausted because my alarm goes off at 7. So I was hoping it was going to get shut off so I could close my eyes again for the next, like, 28 minutes, whatever it was. But 4 minutes go by, alarm's not shutting off. So I'm like, oh, my God. I'm like, Isaiah, why isn't he not waking up? He told me he wakes up from the alarm, and he just wakes up. He's a light sleeper. So I'm like, I literally thought to myself, did a murderer come in and kill everyone? I swear to God I had that thought. I was like, because they definitely think this is my alarm because this definitely doesn't happen every single day, and I'm the guest here. So they're all up, and they think it's my alarm, but it's not my alarm, and I know the truth that it's Isaiah's alarm. So Isaiah's phone's on Do Not Disturb, and I called it like three times. So I went through the Do Not Disturb.
Yeah.
Called his phone, shut off the alarm. I was like, thank God. It was now like 6:42 at the time. So I was like, dude, you know what? Brush my teeth, use the bathroom, start making my food. So I brush my teeth. I put on, I sleep shirtless and like in just shorts.
Yeah.
I bundle myself up, bro. It was so cold. I go outside, go to the kitchen, start prepping food. I look at the couch, and Isaiah's sleeping on the couch, shirtless, hand in his pants, and like, just shorts, no blanket, asleep, with his phone next to him. And my first thought was like, so confused. I understood why he was sleeping out there. I was like, all right, he's a prep. Maybe the puppy was annoying last night, fresh puppy, you know? So I was like, makes sense why he's out here. But I was like, this doesn't make sense. Why did he not wake up? And why is he, like, he's definitely freezing. So I was like, you know what? Kid must be really exhausted. I'll give him 10 minutes. And at 7 o'clock, I'll wake him up because, he, you know, he set up videographers for the workout and everything like that. So, like, he's got to wake up at some point.
Mm.
So I go to try to wake him up the first time, right? I give him, like, a nice nudge. I'm like, Isaiah. Nothing. So my I'm like, God damn it, bro. I'm like, I got to give him a big nudge. I don't want to be rude. Like, what if he wakes up, he's like pissed off, like, ugh, you know? So I give him like a bigger nudge. Isaiah. And then I got some action. He like opened his eyes, went like this, right? He went. So I was like, this motherfucker woke up a little bit, went back to sleep. Confused. So like, I kind of like step back and I'm like, I'm really about to do this again. So I give him a good shake this time, right? I'm like, yo, Isaiah. But the same thing. Eyes would go. So I'm concerned now. I'm like, what the fuck's going on? So like 3 minutes go by. I sent you a video.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, I'm recording it because I'm not trying to be funny. I just didn't know what the fuck was going on. And I was like, what is going on, you know? And I sent them to you.
Right.
So I literally recorded one video to shake him, wake him up, nothing. I set it up as a tripod. And I had water. Just in case, like, bro, pouring water on the kid, he will wake up. So I tried. I poured water on his shoulder. Same thing. He would go. And then I poured on his head. Same thing. Would not wake up. So now, like, 25 minutes, 30 minutes have gone by. Confused. And I was, like, thinking, like, all right, I got to get Noel. I got to get someone. I'm, like, I don't know what to do. I don't want to walk in Noel's room. That's really weird. I was, like, what do I do? I thought he was having sleep paralysis. Sleep paralysis, like when like you're stuck in your sleep, yeah, you can't move, and like you're like a demon or some shit. I look it up, and sleep paralysis only lasts, it says like seconds to 2 minutes max. And I was literally about to go to like knock on Noel's door. She comes out with the puppy to take it out to pee. I was like, holy shit, thank God, Noel. I'm like, come here.
What's the first thing you said to her?
I was like, Noel, come here, look at your boyfriend. She was like, what do you mean? I was like, he's not waking up. So that me saying that, maybe I should use better choice of words, scared her. She's like, what do you mean, not waking up? I was like, give him a shake. And she's like, what? I was like, try to shake him, wake him up. I was like, he will not wake up. So she goes, does the same thing. And she's like, what's happening? I was like, I don't know. Like, I don't know. So she's scared. She calls her mom. She's talking to her mom. And Noelle's mom was just like, you know, he's in. She doesn't use the word prep, but she's like, the kid works really hard.
Yeah.
He never gives himself a break. He's going to wear himself down. Like, he really needs to, like, relax sometimes. He doesn't do that. So, like, I don't know. Like, whatever. And she's like, maybe you guys should just call 911 to be safe. And my first thought, which I was like, maybe it's a little extreme because I didn't know, bro.
Right. You don't know.
And I called 911. Noelle's, like, looking at Isaiah, just, like, watching him not waking up. But, like, he was awake because, you know, I mentioned his eyes would open. And I saw him, his chest breathing. Like, it wasn't like he wasn't breathing. It just looked like he was stuck asleep. So I called 911, gave the same information I just told you. Gave him the address. They're like, all right, first responders are on their way. Like, stay on the line. I was like, all right.
Where's Chris at this point?
Chris is still asleep.
Okay.
Chris is still asleep. Noelle's with me. Puppy's there. Cats are there. So then the operator says, I need you to look at him. Is he breathing? I was like, yeah, he is clearly breathing. I can see his chest rise and fall, and I can hear like a slight snore. Not like, but like
a little bit.
Yeah. And the operator, when she heard that, she freaked out. She's like, he's not breathing. You need to get him on the floor and give him CPR right now. I was like, what? So I swear to God, bro, when I heard that, I like adrenaline just like kicked in.
Yeah.
Which I was, I was CPR certified because I was a lifeguard. So I have done the courses I've done on dummies. Like I know what to do, but like real life situation, never did this at a pool. It's happening right now at my friend's house. First morning at in LA. So when Noelle heard we got to give him CPR to get him on the floor, she started bawling, which I expect out of like most girls, if any, if not all girls, when it's your boyfriend, you know, which I was, I'm pretty proud of myself. I say pretty like,
level-headed,
yeah. calm, you know? So grabbed him, we got his arms, we put him onto the floor.
Was he heavy?
No. Come on. You know that answer. No, he wasn't heavy. He's on the floor. And she's instructed me how to do CPR, you know, put your left palm between his nipples on his sternum, get on top, and then press 2 inches deep, 2 times a second. She's like, I need you to count for me. So I'm in it. I'm giving Isaiah CPR, you know, pressing down. And then she's like, I need you to count, sir. So I'm out of breath. Dude. I did it for 8 minutes until first responders combined. I'm doing like 1, 2, 3. And I always forget to stop. And then she's like, sir, you need to count. I'm like, 7, 8, 9, 10. Like, I never got past, like, 12. Like, I always stopped counting.
Right.
But I was constantly giving him CPR. You know, I wasn't thinking to count while giving the kid a CPR.
Yeah, it's a lot.
So, first responders and come.
When you were doing that for the 8 minutes, you said? Was there any change in his behavior? Nothing?
No. So, Isaiah was on the floor. He was still out of it. He literally, his head was like, just go like that because I'm pumping him. Chris came out at this point. Chris woke up because I'm sure he heard.
It's Chris's first thoughts.
He comes over to me just shocked, like, I knew he was like scared, probably didn't know what the fuck to do. I'd be in the same situation when something's already happening. You're like, how do I help? Scared to help? I was like, bro, just go comfort Noelle. Like, it's obviously handled to the most it can be right now. So just go comfort Noelle. Because Noelle was just crying, understandingly, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, first responders come. It's the firefighters. That's pretty typical in LA because LA is just hugely popular. I'm sure getting 911 calls all the time. Firefighters came, which. They came, like, all right, we got this from here. They assessed him. They did everything. There's plenty of them. They asked for his name, his license, you know, what happened, blah, blah, blah. Give him all the information I could. You put oxygen on him. They put, like, an IV in him. They do all these tests. And they go, his blood sugars are 35. When I heard that, I was like, oh, shit, that's low.
Yeah, it's low.
Because I know typically, like, below 80 is, like, when you eat again, right? After, like, a good couple hours, below 70, something like that.
Generally, after you wake up in the morning, like, you're going below, like, 80 throughout the day, like that's not common that way.
So when I heard 35, I was like, that is dangerously low. So I saw them like inject him with I think it's a dextrose. I don't know what it was, but they inject him with sugar. Mm-hmm. And police came. There was like 3 cops, I think 4 firefighters, and like 2 paramedics ended up coming. So they took it over. They're asking me some questions. You know, does he take anything? He's open online, you know. He's prepping for a show. I told him what he takes there because I wasn't going to hide anything.
Yeah.
Told him that. They go, was there any funny business last night? Did he do any illegal drugs? I was like, no. We took an edible. Edibles from a dispensary. I was like, that was it. And yeah, I kind of got a video of it. He kind of woke up a little bit on the floor when his blood sugar raised to like 170. But when I spoke to Isaiah a little bit after, he doesn't recall any of that. He doesn't recall anything until when he woke up at like 1 p.m. in the hospital later that day. And this was not like around 8 a.m.
Right.
So they put him on the stretcher. They take him out. The firefighter told me, he's like, you didn't have to give him CPR. I was like, listen, operator told me to.
Operator said.
He was like, no, like totally. Like, he's like, it's better that you did than didn't. He was like, he just wasn't in a situation where he needed it. He was, you know. I was like, all right, cool, whatever. But yeah, took him to the hospital. Then I had to stay and dog sit because they got a new puppy.
Right.
And obviously, Noelle's going to the hospital. Chris is going to the hospital. So I was like, shit. I was like, all right. So I got chilled at home with the puppy for a little bit. I think it was like 8 till maybe like 3. I don't know. What is that? 4, 7 hours?
Yeah.
So my tattoo guy. I was like, yo, bro. I was like.
Got an emergency situation.
Yeah. But so basically what they came to the conclusion was he had seizures in his sleep, which I don't know. They don't know what caused it, which him seizing all that night. Is that a word, seizing? Whatever. Multiple him seizures. Having those multiple seizures caused his blood sugar to drop. And they said he also had a couple seizures on the ride in the ambulance. So I woke up in the hospital, and the first thing he said is like, where am I? I have to work out with Anthony. And which is, you know, very nice. Thank you. But worry about what was going on, man. Made him meals. He brought, got his food for him. He kept trying to keep him on plan. That's what he wanted. I'm not going to say no. He wanted that. So helped out. Gave him some meals. He had to stay overnight. They ran a bunch of tests. And in conclusion, they didn't find anything that was wrong with him. They said everything looks normal. We don't know what caused this. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I kind of kept you updated, obviously, because you're his coach as well.
Right.
Right? So that was fucking scary. When I was going through my head, when all this shit started happening, my thoughts were Joe Stedics. Like, not even trying to be scary or sad or use his name. Yeah. Like, situation like this happened in front of my eyes. Bodybuilding. I'm a bodybuilder. I'm, like, fucking scared when this happened. And I thought to myself, I was like, bro, if I watch him go at this moment, I don't know what I'm doing with bodybuilding. I might be done.
Right.
That was scary as shit. I don't like, you know. So I'm glad I was there. Glad I was able to help him. Glad, you know, because
for sure, I think it's who knows what would have happened, right? I don't want to speculate that he would have not been with us today. But it was good that you were there.
Yeah,
made the right decision with Noel's mom suggesting to call 911.
For sure.
No, who knows how much longer you could have continued. Right?
I said, yeah, it was because of her. She really called it.
Yeah, when he was there, the first thing he said was, well, he sent me a picture on the stretcher. I think he FaceTimed me.
Isaiah did.
Yeah,
on the stretcher.
Not the stress, whatever, the medical bed.
Oh, okay, right? In the hospital.
And he's like, hey, baby, I'm good. You know how he talks. And he's just like, I'm on my plan. I'm like, in my head, I'm like, fucking idiot.
Dude.
But I'm like, I'm glad you're okay. And he's just like, so like, what's the plan for today? And I'm just like, Isaiah, like,
you survive.
Like, come on, man. Like, let's just reel it back. I appreciate, like, the tenacity you have. You want to get better, but...
Oh.
You realize what almost just happened, right? Like, let's get some answers. And he's just like, okay, like, should I stay? I said, yes. Like, I need you to get X, Y, and Z tests, right? So I told Noel the same thing. Like, they will, as a hospital, and again, like, for listeners that work in hospitals, I'm just calling it as I see it, they will do anything to get you out.
Really?
Yeah, of course. So they don't care at the end of the day. As long as you're alive, they will send you on your way. They'll do as minimal tests as possible, and that's it. So in his situation... What occurred is not normal, right? They chalk it up as, I think in the report I have, it shows like performance-enhancing drugs is the reason that he was, you know, in this state.
Mm-hmm.
That's obviously tons of people use things.
Yeah.
That doesn't happen every day. If it did, that's a different story.
Yeah.
So it's like, hey, Isaiah, you know, let's have some scans of your brain. Let's make sure everything looks good. So there were a couple of series of tests that he had asked for that they weren't going because he told me what they were going to do at first. And there were things that were not there. So long story short, despite getting all those tests, there was no concluding evidence as to why this happened, which is scary.
Yeah.
So since then, you know, when he was in the hospital, I had him order a glucose monitor. And basically every day, you know, obviously in the morning I have him testing after all the meals. In between meals, I have him testing just to monitor where things are because for some reason, I don't know why it dropped so much. You know, it wasn't like we... And we dieted, this is the second time that we ever are aiming to do a show. The diet that he had last year, significantly harder.
Yeah.
Significantly lower in calories. So it's not like I'm pushing him, right? Yeah. Now, speaking as Isaiah as a person, really hard worker, doesn't sit down, always on the go.
Yep.
I always encourage him, hey, take a step back. You're putting a lot of stress in your body, lower levels of body fat, pushing yourself in the gym. You train a lot harder than you used to. All these things accumulate over time, right? And they compound to ultimately just stress on the body. So you need to kind of chill a little bit, especially if you really want to do a show and make improvements. As you know, you need rest days. You need to kind of chill. His rest days always comprised of doing tons of activities.
Work. Yeah.
So that's my main concern. Since then, it's pretty much been on a day-by-day thing. I've changed his food sources to be a more balanced diet. So definitely different from how I usually prep people.
So what? Like what?
So, you know, where he's in prep, with what we're looking to accomplish, he's lean, but he's not like peeled. Right?
I've noticed that. We talked about that. Yeah.
So there's certain areas, you know, his chest, like you said, chest, shoulders have made substantial improvements, very lean striations, abdominal section, not so much. Right. So that's accumulation of a combination rather of how he trains the muscle that's there,
mm-hmm.
perhaps some digestive issues that are going on. Right.
Yep.
So as far as the food sources, he was one that he always loved rice.
Yeah.
He used a lot of jasmine rice.
He's
kind of moved away from everything. Now, I think we have rice and maybe one meal, very low amount. It's like 31 grams of dry weight for Isaiah. So the rest of his carbs, we have just lower glycemic index carbs. So we have sweet potatoes, oatmeal. If not one of those two, we'll use some rice cakes. We don't do quinoa because, I know he doesn't like that. But different approach, right? A lot of slower digestive things to keep that blood level a little bit more stable.
Okay.
And then just staying on top of him, making sure everything, we had a fortunate enough chance when he was in the hospital to get blood work so we can see where levels are for other things, not hormone-based, but just see his lipid profile. So, and then the other suggestion I gave him, you had mentioned that, though it's legal, the edible, perhaps his body has some kind of reaction to that.
Yeah.
I don't know. Obviously, you mentioned before, even the edible, it wasn't the first time he did it, but coming back from the gym, he started to have some symptoms that, looking back, makes sense of very low blood sugar now. How long that's been going on for, he never really mentioned.
So it was his first time it ever happened.
Yeah. So
cold sweats.
Thus far, like I said, it's been about a week. So in total, since
It happened Monday. It's been a week.
Yeah. So about a week.
Tuesday.
There was one instance where the blood sugar was below 60 thus far.
Damn.
So I always have him carrying glucose. No, I think it was after a meal that was very low in carbs, a little bit of fats. So that's where, again, it's just more every single day at this point. He sends pictures. I give him a diet, and I just try to keep everything very evenly spread. So if he's having 150 grams of carbs a day, it's pretty much every meal. Has the same amount of carbs, same amount of fats, stuff like that, just to keep things as stable as possible. He's moving in the right direction. He has hopes of doing a prep and continuing. But, the first thing I thought of, I have a client that might not be with us. Like, that's scary, right? As you mentioned, firsthand experience for you. On my end, I remember I was quadding in Greece.
You were what?
I was quadding.
Oh, driving quads.
Yeah. And my pocket's vibrating, and I'm like, who the hell is calling me, right? Like, someone is calling me. And then I saw it's you. And, like, for me, whenever I get a bunch of messages, I always try to scroll to the top. Like, I don't want to, like, ruin the surprise, But I couldn't help but see, like, the last message was, like, what the hell? And then above that, I see, like, videos of Isaiah. So I'm like, all right, let me click into, like, a random one. And the videos of his face. And now here I am, right? I'm thinking Isaiah's, like, wants to be an aspiring actor. He's pretty good at entertaining.
In one of the videos I said, are you acting?
Yeah. So I said in my head, I remember speaking out loud. I'm like, are they like sick? Like, why the fuck would they send me this and waste my time right now? Like, Isaiah's pretending to be dead? Like, what the fuck is this? And the reality was that, no, he was like this in a paralysis state, multiple seizures. And so that was, as I'm seeing it, like, video by video, I'm like, oh my God. And then I said, how's it going? You're like, not good, bro. And then you sent me a video of the paramedics, and I'm like, oh my God, like,
this
is really bad. So, again, I just remind Isaiah, take things a day at a time, like anybody in life.
Yeah.
Plan a day at a time. He has aspirations to do a show. I hope he can get there. But I want him to get there and be healthy. That's what I seek for anyone. So then,
I remember when he was able to get released, right? His parents came over because they told him, obviously. Or Noel mentioned, like, what happened, and that's their baby. Mm-hmm. So they flew out to L.A. to obviously go see their child. And they're obviously concerned. They're like, Isaiah, like, relax. Like, please, like, put your foot on the brake a little bit. And the first thing Isaiah was like, he was, like, texting me. He's like, yo, can you bring me my supplements? He's like, I don't want to be off plan. Bring me my food, which the food, fine, you know? Sure. Supplements, I was like, bro, I'm not handing your supplements to your dad. I'm like, I'm not doing that.
Right.
And then right after when he got released, this is my shoot day. He got released on that day. So I was busy the whole day. And the first thing he did when he got home was he wanted to go to the gym. And his parents were like, Isaiah, come on, like, take it easy. Which I think he only went for like 30 minutes, he said.
Yeah.
But I'm sure, like, he wanted to get a pump in or some shit like that. But I was like, damn, bro, like, something like that should be a big wake-up call. I feel like the first time is like, all right, like, it happened. Like, you're going to try to, like, play it off. Like, not ha-ha, but see if I can get away with it. It happens a second time, then you're like, fuck. Like, you're not going to do it again.
Yeah, so.
Which, you hope there's never a second time.
And
but it's fucking scary.
Usually, having an answer or a reason, this is why it happens. It's something to look out for, you can pay attention to. He left with, there is no answer.
No answer.
There is no answer at all. Why I think that glucose was so low, I think that was a, who knows how many seizures he had, how long that was going on. Yeah. Maybe, you said it was at 6:30 he was getting up. Who knows? It could have happened. He texted me that night, actually. It was like 2 a.m.
Yeah, because I remember. So I mentioned all the footsteps, right?
Mm-hmm.
So The footsteps I heard was a mixture of Noelle taking the dog out to pee in the middle of the night. So that's one, and then coming back, two things of footsteps. Isaiah going to the couch because of the dog, three. And then Chris and his girlfriend who came in throughout the night, like hearing those footsteps too. So yeah, Isaiah went out to the couch to sleep because of the puppy.
He texted me to get water, he said, and then he was sleeping.
And he mentioned about the abs, right? Because I talked about his abs.
Yes.
Yeah. So at some point between like 2 a.m. to 3 a.m. to 6:30 is when all this stuff happened.
Yeah.
And it continued to happen till like 8.
And so I imagine his glucose continually dropped steadily. Yeah. Based on the duration that was going on. But yeah, not knowing it, not having an answer is scary. So it's just, again, a reminder, just be mindful, right?
Yeah.
As much as people want to prep and look a certain way, you know, sometimes being able to breathe is more important. So
yeah.
No. Yeah, so far, like I said, Isaiah's doing well. I hear from him every morning, like clockwork, 6 a.m. his time. So it's very nice. Mm-hmm. And I look forward to his messages because I know he's okay, right? That's the scary part. But
I'm going to be at his show. It's in Jersey, right?
His show will be in Jersey.
Yeah, I'll be there.
It's either the first week of November or the second, depending on how things are going. That's the goal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, he's asking me about shorts to wear. Like board shorts. He asked me some suggestions and stuff. No, besides that happening the first day of my trip, obviously don't care that it happened. Happy I was there to help. I had the photo shoot the next day, which was fun. It was in the gym. It was me. It was Lex. It was James. Shizzy. Brandon. Weston. Professional week guy, Chris. Gabe. It was a good crowd. It's like some gym guys. Mm-hmm. It was a gym shoot. We had to do a one take video. So basically, like, there was no cut. So if anyone fucked up, you had to redo the video. Honestly, didn't think it was that much. It took like 8 tries, which wasn't too bad. But it was pretty cool. It was like they had like a whole like setup with like the smooth camera, like a whole attachment on the guy's body. He was holding the big camera. It was a bunch of moving parts of like sled push and compression to like a person walking by, then follow him, and people like working out and stuff. I was doing shoulder press, like oiled me up in baby oil and stuff like that. So it was pretty cool. It was a cool video. We did that, and then we did like a funny meme shoot. Mm-hmm. Do you see the video going on like Instagram? It was security camera footage of a guy inclined dumbbell pressing. Some guy spotted him, and another guy spotted the spotter. Another guy came and spotted that spotter. No,
no, I didn't see that.
I'll just show you. But we recreated that.
Okay.
And that was it. That's what we shot that day. And then that was it. That was really it. And then I just like, did I leave the next day or did I work out? I saw Polo G.
Yes.
I did see Polo G. So that day that happened to Isaiah. Yeah. I worked out later in the day. Pull up to the gym. Weston manages it, you know. And I see this just Rolls Royce Cullivan. I forget the name of the Rolls Royce.
The big one.
The big one. Yeah. Big SUV, huge emblem, blacked out. I was like, damn. I was like, whose car is that? I go in, I go up to Weston, I'm like, bro, whose car is that? He's like, it's Polo G. I was like, what do you mean? And he's like, he's right there. And like, I don't listen to that type of music.
Yeah.
But I know my friend John does. And John sends me his songs, like, honestly, maybe a couple times a month of like cool songs. So I text my friend John. I'm like, yo, you like Polo G, right? He's like, yeah. And I was like, watch this. And I go up to him because he kept getting water and stuff, and I didn't want to bother him. It was like a private gym, you know, and he's there to be private and stuff. But once again, like, I'm also there to be private too, so I was like, whatever. I was like, hey, man, I don't mean to bother you. I was like, can I just get a quick flick? I use the word flicks. It's cooler. And he spoke really softly. He's like, yeah. And then go to the mirror. He took a photo. I'm like, thanks, bro. And he dabbed me up. And he worked out. And that was my trip in L.A., man. Very fortunate to be able to stay at their house, to help Isaiah, to have a kitchen to cook all my food in, because you know what? I didn't miss a meal.
That's great.
I did eat one off-plan meal. I'm sorry, bro.
That's all right.
Actually, the reason why was because I had to give Isaiah one of my meals for when he was in the hospital. And my meal timing, Gary ended up getting us food. The first offer was Chick-fil-A. I was like, nah. Then he got these sandwiches, and I needed the meal at the end of the shoot, and I ate it. And bro, I'll tell you, I downed that sandwich like this big, 3 minutes before everyone else finished it.
No, that's good though. But it's definitely convenient when you're traveling. It can be challenging. A lot of people that travel and they're in prep.
Yeah,
I always get the question, you know, what can I do? And ultimately, you know, there's many different ways to approach it. You can kind of pre-cook things, freeze it, thaw it out when you get there. But the main variable that I find super helpful is getting some kind of like kitchenette, right? Yeah. So if you could stay at Airbnb or you stay at one of those like, can't think of what those hotels are called.
Sweet things?
Yeah, like a Homewood Suites or something.
Oh, the one
like
I stayed at that I hated?
Yeah, but at least it has never like a microwave and it has a stovetop. So that'll help.
Mine didn't have a stovetop. That's why I had to use the electric burner.
Yeah, so I'm saying I think the best thing is to get some type of kitchenette when you travel. Definitely helpful to stay on plan.
Oh, my God. I mentioned it to you. I want to mention it on the podcast. We're talking about some gut shit, right?
Okay.
And I think we fixed it. My stomach doesn't hang as much as it used to, because that was a big thing they were mentioning at the shoot. We were shooting all compression stuff. Compression long sleeves, compression shirts. And bro, me naturally, I've always had a bigger stomach when I'm not shredded. I remember playing soccer and me and Frank, I look at Frank's body, not checking him out, but kind of checking him out, not in a gay way, but just in a way of looking at his physique and, you know, pecs, and then like closer into his body, be his stomach, not protruding, but flat. And my body is pecs. And then a belly. My top abs always stuck out. My top, and that's where your stomach is.
Yeah.
So it's always been that way. Unless I'm like about to compete, it's like flat. So I'm shooting this compression. I'm like in my head, bro. I'm going like this. I'm wearing, you know,
kind of self-conscious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it was bad. So we were kind of like all making jokes, having a good time throughout that day. Shizzy was there. We're all looking at a group photo. He has a tattoo that says "You can't kill me." So I was like, "Lex, I'm like, you think you could kill Shizzy?" And he turned around with the meanest look on his face. I was like, "I'm sorry, bro. I won't mess around again."
Damn.
We were like all doing jokes. And he made a joke about my stomach, and it was cool. It was whatever. But anyways, I come back to Jersey. I was doing my own research because, you know, I like researching a lot of different things. Mm-hmm. And I was reading that probiotics can't thrive without fiber and prebiotics. Mm-hmm. So I was like, you know what? I'm eating sauerkraut, which is a prebiotic. I was like, but I'm not eating any fiber. I eat a banana a day. I have pineapple. I just eat rice and chicken and beef. And I eat oils and nut butter. I'm like, I got no fiber.
No.
So I started out. I was like, you know what? I mentioned it to you. I was like, let me try fiber. So we incorporated oatmeal back in my diet, which is about like 8 grams, 10 grams in the morning. Vegetables in each meal is about 5 grams. Not each meal. In like 3 of my meals, which is about another 15 grams. So that's 25. And then I'd have fiber shake at night, which is about 8 grams. So I'm at 32 grams of fiber, which leaves a little bit above
tremendous difference.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
I guess my question to you is, you're not the only one, right? A lot of people, they just don't like to eat greens.
But I thought fiber was an enemy to me, because whenever I would have fiber, I'd use the bathroom immediately.
Yeah, I guess sometimes people's only experience with intaking a lot of vegetables is like when food's really low, so they'll overeat, and then too much fiber is a bad thing, right?
Okay.
However, on the other flip side, no fiber is also a bad thing.
Yep.
So, I mean, your reasoning was to not have vegetables often, other than not following the plan. What was your rationale, though? Was it because of the poor experience in the past?
The reason not to have vegetables was because, you want to know what it was? Is that my happy realization. Mm-hmm. Because I didn't want to become too full, because obviously in prep, you eat vegetables to kind of fill yourself up, right? But in the off season, I just realized to me why I now incorporate vegetables, it's doing the opposite. I swear to God.
It's helping with digestion.
It's helping digestion. Yeah. I'm hungrier faster between meals. My stomach is flatter. I don't have as much gas. I'm using the bathroom better. So
I think that's all the fiber itself, having that back in your diet.
Mm-hmm.
And then overall, the look, right? Less distension.
So my thought of literally vegetables were making me fuller and, you know, not as hungry was the wrong thought. It was the opposite.
Yeah, in that regard.
Yeah.
I think when people, maybe let's just say they double their intake of vegetables, then it might impede digestion for sure. Or in a big meal, like a pre-workout meal, I don't think greens have a place in a pre-workout meal.
Yeah.
It's not needed. It's just going to slow things down. But, it's definitely, it's healthy to keep greens in a diet for sure.
So I don't even know what the hell that is. Tell me about insoluble and soluble fiber.
Like from a coach, from your coaching perspective, is that like an important factor you keep in mind?
So I think the main thing, right? I guess I always try to assess and ask, hey, how are you feeling when it comes to bowel movements, right? For some people, they might mention, like, Dom, you know, whether they are non-existent, they're exploding, things like that. So that's when you start to look into, okay, right, are we taking any kind of fiber supplement? Because a fiber supplement, let's just say you eat however you're eating, a fiber supplement will directly put fiber into your diet, right? Whereas other people, less frequent, I feel, in our contemporary era versus maybe, like, when you first started bodybuilding, potatoes were, like, super common, right? Yeah. White potato. Now, nobody really eats potatoes anymore.
Why?
I mean, I guess at the end of the day, rice is easier. We do things that are easier. Okay. And sometimes people just don't like putting a baked potato in the microwave. It takes 6-7 minutes to cook. It's tough. I guess they don't want to wait. But rice is super common. However, in doing that, in removing potatoes, we're now missing fiber, right? So I think the main thing is, the only fiber that a lot of kids, I guess, get in when they give me, like, we have somebody sit down, what do you usually eat? The only time I hear any kind of fiber-related food or that's comprised of fiber is oatmeal.
Yeah.
And that's really hit or miss because it's like, hey, I like to have my oatmeal, but I put protein in it. Remove the protein powder. They don't really like oatmeal so much because it's very bland tasting, right? So I think that's something that's important. But I always try to put in a fiber supplement. There's many companies, different flavors that taste great. Yeah. And you wouldn't, back in the day before this existed, like sugar-free Metamucil was like popular.
But is that fiber, right?
Yeah, it's fiber, exactly. Other than that, there was like, trying to think what other, there was another main product for a while that like was popularized. And then now, again, everyone likes a flavor. So you have different good companies that have good flavors.
Yeah.
What are you going to say?
What is insoluble with soluble fiber?
So listen, my stool is soft. What do I do?
Is it always soft, though?
Yep. I told you, bro, a soft serve ice cream machine.
Yeah. But before that, you had said that this is before the fiber. You had no fiber in your diet. Now we're putting fiber back in, right? So, being that's been, what, 3 days?
Uh-huh. All right, so listen,
how
this
has
morning,
your poop changed the last 4 days?
This morning, bro?
Yeah. How much fiber are you having in your drink?
I just told you about one scoop. It's 8 grams.
Okay. And that's at night?
That's at night.
Okay.
With my beef.
With the beef? So yeah. I would have it separate from the beef.
Well, no, it's like 10 minutes after.
Having,
it's like 10
I
minutes after.
I imagine you're having beef and there's vegetables with that?
No. Okay, so listen. The first night, I went crazy with the fiber. I had three bowls of oatmeal, right? I had 40.
What the fuck is the point of that?
Because if I put 120 grams of oats in one bowl, it doesn't.
Oh, that's like, okay, let me just. What? If you skip a workout, can you double tomorrow?
No, relax. Can I just tell you what I did?
Why is fiber different?
Can I tell you what I did?
Go ahead.
So,
here.
In my plan, you have 75 grams of carbs in the morning. So I decided to have 120 grams of oatmeal the first day. All right, so that was about 12 grams of fiber. Then I had vegetables in not pre, not post, but meals 4, 5, and 6. So that each one was about 5 grams of fiber there. So 15 plus 12 is 27, plus the 8 grams from my shake, about 35 grams of fiber. But okay. I told you, my last meal, I pretty much go to bed right after. So I eat my beef. Maybe I like dilly dally for 5 minutes, get my supplements, like my whatever turmeric and stuff. I take it and I'll drink the fiber to flush it down.
Okay.
Then I go to bed.
So after that first day, let's just say your system was kind of overloaded that first day, right? Because you went from minimal to like an overloaded sense, to say the least. The last 24 hours.
Yeah.
How has the change been?
So I mentioned the first time I went to the bathroom the next morning, it was much better. I was like, yo, this is way better than what I told you what the symptoms were before.
Yeah.
Remember the symptoms?
I recall, but you can explain if you'd like.
No. And then this morning, I'll explain. It was a little bit harder to go, but that was awesome because I've never had that, bro. It comes out so easy and it hurts because there's a lot of air with it and there's just like, but it's like, you know, like this morning I kind of had to like focus and push. I had like a harder lock. This is crazy. This is important shit in bodybuilding.
Go ahead.
I had like a harder log, and then there was like miniature harder logs.
Mm-hmm.
And then I kind of sat in the toilet for a little bit longer. So I felt like there was a little bit more, and then it was like a little soft serve ice cream, and I was done.
But that's much better than what it was before, because it used to be like, I told you, like flakes. It'd be like these weirdly like abstract shapes and fuzzy, which is like inflammation and shit, which is no more fuzzy stuff. It's like small little log, like a big log, small little logs, and I had a little soft serve. This is crazy. This is being shared.
As far as, I guess, going back to the breakdown of like soluble and insoluble, most products are going to be comprised of both because you need both, right? But soluble fiber in itself breaks down in water into like a gel-like substance, right? It's going to help with digestion, and it could also be used to improve blood sugar. Case in point, Isaiah, putting in vegetables, things like that.
And this was which one?
Supplement. That's going to be soluble.
Okay.
Okay. Insoluble, it's going to move through your system and it does not break down. So that's going to help loosen stool, stuff like that. Okay. So constipation issues, things like that. That's a reason. So when people speak fiber, there are specific types of fiber, soluble and insoluble. Most supplements that a person would grab off a shelf comprised of both.
Uh-huh.
Oatmeal, for example, going to be more soluble based. Going to break down very easy, as you can kind of understand, right? So as far as what I would use to track that, chronometer.com, right? Little plug for Chronometer, has specifics of everything from, you know, iron, sodium, every little thing that is on the back of a the nutrition facts,
yeah,
is going to be in that.
Okay.
So you can really see, like, okay, I'm taking in 36 grams of fiber. Specifically, this is the type of fiber I'm taking.
Cool.
So I think that's really helpful versus other apps that people use. I'm not familiar with the ones.
Yeah.
I don't think in my experience they had that, right?
It might be in the premium, but I don't pay for that. So, yeah. I don't even use it anymore.
So that's the main thing, right? It's just importance, again, of why you're using fiber, why it's important. If it's a missing component, what happens?
Yeah.
Too much, too little.
So what I've noticed is when I've included fiber now back in my diet is that my bathroom time has been better. The whole experience.
Yeah.
The number two itself, time on there, the release, everything feels much better.
That's good.
It ain't no perfect one log.
It's not perfect yet, so we need to kind of work on that. But also, we might have
some
lingering.
I honestly, for as long as I can remember,
you'd never had.
I have never had a normal number two. I remember.
So there's a high likelihood, right, that there is a chance something you're eating, body doesn't really agree with, and you just consistently always ate it. Whether that
maybe
is
bananas, always eating bananas.
For some people, that their bodies are there's alert allergens that we're just not susceptible of.
But you know what's weird?
Digesting.
I know this is a real thing, and it's like, I don't know what the right word is, but it's like anxiety-driven, what's that word where it's like IBS?
Yeah.
So, like, I remember whenever I would have, like, a hard exercise, whenever I played soccer, and I would sprint and play a soccer game or soccer practice, I'd have to go number two so bad, and it wasn't good. I've always had that. In the gym now, it's not like that, but sometimes.
So, it's kind of like a... Like you said, anxiety-driven, stress-driven.
Yeah.
I think that's common. And I guess the only thing is, other than having stress management tools in place so you're not feeling so anxious and bound up, would probably be helpful. But that's no different than, I guess, you know, some people get butterflies or something, like going up to bat or game's going to start, whatever.
Uh-huh.
It's just different reactions that our bodies have. So even if we're backstage, you know, there's been plenty of times where if all of a sudden you start to feel really warm and you start to sweat, that's like cortisol spiking. Like, that's not a great look. You don't want to all of a sudden freak out backstage.
Okay.
So overthinking, a lot of it, again, has to do with how our mind plays a role with everything that goes on in our body. So if we start to have these thoughts and we're facilitating negative things to transpire in our mind, it goes somewhere. It does something to us.
It's crazy. So I was doing some more research, right? And I learned what bile is to a degree. Not really.
Mm.
But what is bile?
So bile is going to be an acid, right? That's in our stomach, right? Okay. So the reason when we take prescription drugs and things like that, we start to mess with our overall balance that's in our stomach. You don't want to have too much acid, too less acid, right? So what we'll do, I think it'd be really helpful, is maybe I could talk to Dom on the side if sharing some of his case is permissible.
Okay.
Right, in a public forum. But I think that's like a real-life example of what occurs in a typical person, right, they're taking PPIs, protein pump inhibitors. That's like...
the fuck is that?
Like Pepsin GI, stuff like that you might see.
Oh, okay.
So when people... A very common thing is acid reflux. We can discuss what acid reflux is in a general sense, in a complex sense, and we can kind of have like a segment on that. That'd be helpful. And then if we have a case in point like Dom's example to use, I think that'd be something that's pretty cool and unique. That'd be really helpful. But yeah, then there's other digestive enzymes and a whole route of
like betaine, HCL.
There's different, exactly. So our digestive enzymes, right, in itself, they're gonna ultimately, what do they do in the most simplistic sense? They help break down our food.
Yeah.
The most readily available digestive enzyme in our body, saliva, right?
Yes.
That's going to help us.
First form of breaking down
that's
digestion.
The most important one, right? So sometimes like that is a missing point for a lot of people, right?
Damn.
But then there are other products now that are popularized, like a ravenous or something like that. But that, you don't, we're not controlling the blend. There's oxbile built into that. So for some people, they don't need more acid in their stomachs. They don't need more oxbile to break down fats. Whereas for other people, perhaps they do, or perhaps they just need some assistance breaking down larger protein meals. Or that's where the butane, HCL, things like that.
Butane is called?
What happened?
What's called butane?
B-E-T-A-I-N-E. HCL, that's one. There's,
I was pronouncing it wrong. I just didn't know that.
I'm trying to think of some other ones.
Because I was doing research on TUDCA.
That's going to be more for, that also helps. That's just more for liver dysfunction.
Yes. This one video, it was like TUDCA versus oxbile. And I was like, I clicked it. I was kind of understanding it to a degree, but it was very, it was complex for me.
So, I mean, the liver, that plays a role. Stomach, let's just say there's something wrong with their GI tract, right? If left untreated, other than the visible symptoms of someone being distended, bloating, not shitting, shitting themselves, you also, when left untreated, can start to play a role in liver dysfunction, things like that. So now things are not breaking down. We're not metabolizing estrogen, perhaps, because of this. So think of the stomach like the second brain in our head.
Yeah.
It's been proven through science that diseases and stuff take place because of our stomach.
That's so crazy, dude.
So, but I think that'd be cool to like go into. I think it'd be helpful.
Yeah.
For a lot of people. I'm going to just, we'll structure it so that like people can really relate. I think the more things that people can relate to, the more helpful and useful information can be.
No, I agree. I totally agree.
We could either end the,
we're just shy of an hour right now. We could continue it. I have kind of an idea for a segment.
Sure.
Those texts I sent you last night, I was reminiscing on those emails. Would you like to go over my questionnaire? Would you like to read through that with me?
Go ahead.
You want to?
Can if you'd like.
All right, so Kyle, last night I sent you a text. Yeah. There was a copy of the Team ProFX questionnaire as long as some old emails between us two. I don't know what made me go down this rabbit hole, but I do know why. I wanted to review old diets you gave me.
Mm.
So I was looking at our old messages, and I think it'd be really funny to go over this questionnaire we went through. Because I remember you always mentioning, I give you my school schedule, I never recalled it, and it was in this questionnaire. So, do you still do this questionnaire, by the way?
No, I do use, like, Jotform now, so it's, like, more, I guess, in line with technology advancing. Because that was more manual, a lot of writing on your part.
It was. So you had your basic shit in here. Before we're able to start working together, I will need you to carefully answer the below questions. Did you handwrite that part, or is that, like, copy and paste it from somewhere?
I mean, the first, I hand wrote it once and then I typed it once rather than it's handwritten, right?
All right, so this was in August of 2019. So over 4 years ago now. 4 years ago now.
Wow.
All right, basic shit stats. That was 17, 5'10, 180. What is your current daily schedule like? Please be as specific as possible. Include things such as time you wake up, the time you eat, go to work, train, etc. Please list your weekend schedule. Currently in summer, I work as a lifeguard, which doesn't have a set schedule for hours. Every day I wake up around 8 a.m. Typically, my most common shift is 9:30 to 6. I eat meal 1 at 8:30, meal 2, smaller meal 11:45, meal 3 at 3, meal 4, pre-workout meal at 6:15, meal 5, post-workout 9, meal 6, 10:30.
Mm-hmm.
What is your work schedule? I include all allotted breaks you are given. If you have a job, please inform me on the occupation. I am a pool lifeguard, which means sitting in a chair and doing nothing while you work your whole shift. I can practically eat whenever I want on the job. I don't have a set lunch break, and I give you the shifts I worked. This is just nutrition-related you have on here. Please be detailed and truthful as possible. If you're not a nutrition program of any type, please list the foods you have been consuming. 17-year-old aunt. I eat as of now whatever. I make sure I get 180 to 190 grams of protein in and over 400 grams of carbs. Typical foods I eat every day are Okios or Greek yogurt, all-time favorite food, bananas, muffins, eggs, English muffins, tuna, chicken, steak, rice, pasta, pure protein bars or protein powder, sweet potatoes, and peanut butter.
What did you think of that diet? So 17.
I mean, you kind of just named every food possible that you could eat. That's somewhat clean.
Because that's what I ate every single day.
Sure.
That's typical shit. What are some foods you feel that I generally do well with? Yogurt is a go-to food. I enjoy it also does well with me. Sweet potatoes as well, because I haven't been a strict real diet any longer than 2 weeks. I can eat typically, I eat calorically dense foods as of now. All right, nothing crazy yet. What are some foods you don't feel agree with you? I don't dislike anything, and nothing also disagrees with me, is what I said. Do you accumulate fat easily? No.
I agree with that.
What is the heaviest weight you've ever obtained? 185? What is the highest daily carb intake? Right around 350 to 400.
That was it?
I mean, I'm sure I hit more, but like on a daily basis, 400 grams.
Wow.
Training related. I've been training for 3 years at the time. I give you my training split. It was like a push-pull legs. I gave you my workout too. I actually remember filling this out. It was at the pool I was lifeguarding at the time with the boss, the supervisor's daughter, who's cool. She's a little bit older than me. She's like a lot older than me. She was 26, 28 at the time. But I remember writing this down. What time do I prefer to train? After meal 1 or meal 4? 7 a.m. or 6:30? Work schedule dependent. What is your, this is my favorite. Me and Allie cracked up about this last night. You ready?
What's the question? Let me see.
What is your current cardio regimen? How many days, weeks, months have you been doing this for? Try to guess what my answer is here. Okay.
I don't currently do any cardio aside from playing like soccer.
Yeah.
No?
This is true. Occasionally, I would do a high resistance bike for 100 calories in 6 minutes, 3 times a week, but it isn't consistent. So random and so true.
And that's this what time, you did?
When I was a junior in high school, if I thought I was getting fat, I would just do the resistance bike, put it super high up because I got like a quad pump, thinking I was working out my legs. Mm. And I burn 100 calories really quick. I was like, all right, like I'm good. Kept me lean.
That works for you.
Just typical shit about the gym. What gym do I train at? Any injuries? No. PED and supplement related. What supplements are you currently taking? This includes over-the-counter subs, any vitamins, etc. God of Rage pre-workout, L-arginine protein powder, and creatine monohydrate. Are you using any PEDs? I listened to some SARMs I was on.
You did?
Yeah. This is my favorite, though. PED budget. How much per month can you comfortably and willingly spend?
Yeah.
You know how much I put?
80.
80 bucks a month.
Yeah, it was just fucking a multivitamin pre-workout.
There's some other. Oh, short term. What is your ultimate goal in the sport? Short term, get my feet wet, competing, and understand what it's all about, and win T Nationals in 2020, which never happened. Long term, IFBB Pro.
Yeah, you never even tried for T Nationals.
No. Why are you choosing to be part of Team Pro FX? Heard great things from Jersey Shore Supplements about you. Also been following you, Kyle, and Phil Viz for a while, learning as much as I can via social media.
Hey, read that again, the answer.
Why am I choosing to be part of Team Pro FX? So I, you know how Phil Viz is visual FX or Viz FX?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, sometimes I'd fucking be dyslexic and think it was the same thing because the logos are almost identical. Yeah. Why is that?
I don't know.
So, yeah, I mixed you and Phil Viz together, which actually you guys were a part of each other one day.
Yeah, it's time.
List any additional information that you believe will assist me. Can't think of anything as of now, but anything comes up, I'll be sure to tell you ASAP. No, it was cute. It was good shit, man.
2019, wow.
We had some good emails going back and forth here. I sent you a photo of like my old...
Most of the photos are gone now. They don't save.
You mentioned that to me because I deleted that Google account or some shit. I cleared my storage, so I lost a lot of the check-in photos from that time.
That's shitty.
But I did send you my first ever photos of... I was like, hey, my name is Anthony Mattel. This is my physique. Mm-hmm. I'm this age. The initial email.
And that was all to my old email.
You don't have this one anymore?
I have, but I don't use it.
Did you see the text I sent you last night where it said best A? You used to do that. You used to go best K.
Best K, yeah. I think I still do.
Hi, Kyle. I'm a 17-year-old from Jackson, New Jersey, competing on November 9th. Look at that, dude. That was like, I wasn't like, and I want to compete. And competing on November 9th in the Eastern USA Championship for my first ever show. I plan on doing men's physique and classic physique, I said. And was curious on pricing for an 8-week prep
or what prices you have for different time frames of a contest prep. If you need to see who I am, my Instagram is at Anthony Mantello. I look forward to hearing from you. Hey, man, first and foremost, I want to thank you for reaching out to me in this email. I hope to provide you with information that I'm not only answering your first question, but a few more to formulate in your head thereafter. And then you had a fucking long-ass copy and paste email.
Yeah. That was 2019. I remember that one.
Sure.
It's crazy. I can't believe it was so long ago. Yep. It feels like, I mean, it feels like even longer. I guess it's not too long, but it feels very long ago. Damn.
I knew that one was impressive. I was like, I got to include that one. Side tricep.
Not bad. Shredded. $80 budget. Shredded.
There's a little
you
more.
Gotta bring back the hair.
No. That barber, he's a nice guy. But he would just fade it all the way up to the top and then just leave the mushroom. Yeah,
literally.
And I would specifically go in there and be like, no mushroom top, please. Just never worked.
Mushrooms.
Oh my god, I have our first diet.
You really? Yeah, you ease out or no? You bulked for a little bit.
I bulked for a little bit. The highest I ever got to was 186. Do you want to see what my base diet was? This will be the last clip of the podcast. All right, so I remember this because I was like, I remember the first diet you gave me, I actually lost weight. It went to like 178 maybe, and then we gained weight. We got up to 186.
Yep.
But, all right, day 1, 3, and 6. 12 ounces of egg whites, which I would drink.
Mm-hmm.
80 grams of oats. 1 light and fake Greek yogurt. 2 grams of fish oil, which I never had. A multivitamin, never had. Matador, never had. 6 ounces of lean protein. 4 ounces of sweet potato, or 100 grams of quinoa. I guess that is sweet potato.
Okay, what?
Quinoa.
Quinoa. Quinoa?
I used to call quinoa quinoa, and I still do on accident.
Yeah, cool.
Half a tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil. Meal 3, 6 ounces of flank steak, 100 grams of rice, 1 cup of veggies. I would have flank steak and rice. I remember that. No veggies. And 500 milligrams of BCM95. I never knew what the fuck that was, so I never had it. Mm-hmm. That is curcumin, yeah. Pre-meal, 6 ounces of protein, 90 grams cream of rice or 300 grams of rice, 100 grams of banana. Is that my sister?
No.
Post-workout, 7 ounces of protein, 60 grams of Golden Crisp cereal. I remember, oh my God, I remember Golden specifically Crisp. Getting that, bro. Because you had that in there, I was like, what the fuck is
That's
this?
It's a sugar and rice blend. Or oats, actually.
300 grams of jasmine rice. Last meal of the day, 6 meals. 6 ounces of lean protein, 2 whole eggs, 2 ounces of avocado, 1 cup of veggies, 1 serving of fiber, 2 grams of fish oil. I never took the supplements, honestly.
You never took the supplements, but you took the SARMs.
Jeez, man. Yeah.
You didn't miss that one, huh?
Oh, nope. I did not.
Oh, it's okay, man. Look where you are now.
I know.
I'm still breathing. It's good.
All right, we're going to end it there before I have a horrible joke to make.
A lot of people here.
There is, but all right. That was episode 9. I think it was a pretty good one. Right? You liked it?
I thought it was a great conversation, Anthony.
Cool, man. So thank you guys for watching episode 9 of the Iron Brothers podcast. My name is Anthony. That is Sir Kyle over there. We have Grant behind the camera. You can use all our discount codes for Young LA. We have code Grant. We have code Ant. We have code Sir. And that is going to conclude it. We'll see you next week with episode 10. Toodaloo. That was fucking good.
Sounds like you're reading off a goddamn script.
My eyes are closed and I can read through my head.